Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Beis Halevi in his Maimar Bitachon. And we mentioned in the previous class when we were learning out of the Sefer that the Beis Halevi introduces 2 points about the Maimar, about the advantages of a person that relies in Hashem. Number one, says the Beis Halevi, that a person will be lacking nothing in this world as a result of his Bitachon. He will obtain whatever it is that he needs. And number two, he should be informed that the reward that will be waiting for him in the world to come is going to be astronomically great. So the issue that the Mefarshim, the commentators have with these words of the Beis Halevi is that he seems to be saying that a person is going to share his reward in this world for whatever you are hoping for and trusting in from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, says the Beis Halevi, you're going to receive. And number two, there'll be a reward waiting for the person in Olam Haba, in the world to come. However, we know the very famous words in Chazal that tell us, Schar mitzvah b'hayam alaka. There is no reward for a mitzvah in this world. That means, generally speaking, the way that the Gemara and Rav Dessler explains that Gemara is that since that a mitzvah is something that is ruchnius, it's spiritual, it is something that is has a helikite, a holiness that is attached to it. It is the utensil, so to speak. It is the vehicle, the means, which brings us close to Hashem. So therefore, how is it possible that a person could receive a reward in this transient physical world that we live in? If I do a mitzvah, I wrap my arm in tefillin, I daven Shmon Esrei, I learn 1,000 words of Torah, I keep kosher, I say brachas, whatever the mitzvahs are that I am doing, how is it possible that HaKadosh Baruch Hu could repay me for that in this physical world when the act of the mitzvah is the most ruchni, the most spiritual thing that a person can do? And that is why that the true reward for a mitzvah is waiting for the person, not in this world, not in the physical, immaterial world, but rather it is waiting for them. The Keren Kayemis, the principal reward for that person, is waiting for them in Olam Haba, in the world to come, when they will leave this world, when they will travel into the world of neshamis, of souls. They will be enveloped in Kedusha, in Ruchnius, in holiness and spirituality and sanctity. And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to laden them with the true reward that they earned for the mitzvahs they did down here. You cannot, that's what the Gemara is telling us, you cannot receive true spiritual reward in a world which is engulfed in physicality. The real reward for spirituality, for the Kedusha that we did in our lives, the mitzvahs that we were involved with, that's only going to be found in the world to come. However, we do also find a Maimer Chazal that the sages teach us that mitzvah is goyreres mitzvah. One mitzvah brings about another mitzvah. If you do one, you ignite inside of yourself this burning desire to do mitzvahs, and that will lead you to do more and more and more and more until you become a mitzvah boy or a mitzvah girl. You become a person that their life is revolving around mitzvahs. And therefore, explains Rav Dessler, although that it's true that you cannot really get all the reward for a mitzvah in this world, because that's spiritual, and the real spiritual content of reward is waiting in the world to come. Nevertheless, the reward that you could gain in this world is that if one mitzvah is goyreres mitzvah, it brings you to another one. That if you are spiritually charged up in this world, and you have a burning desire to do more mitzvahs for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to be able to do His will and be Mekadosh Shem Shemayim, to sanctify His name, what greater reward could there be for a person in this world that he's going to live his life in the proper way? He's going to be enthusiastic about Torah, about mitzvahs, about keeping himself on the Derech HaYosha, on the straight path. There is nothing greater than that. It helps to go past so much of the inertia and so much of the things that are holding us back in this world, when the neshama is nisgarer, it is charged up and fired up to be able to do the mitzvah of Hashem. Says the Beis Halevi over here, a person that is b'teach b'Hashem, there's two milas, there are two advantages that such a person has. Number one, if you rely on HaKadosh Baruch Hu, So firstly, he writes, you will certainly obtain whatever it is that you are lacking. And number two, the reward, the ultimate reward will be waiting for you in the world to come. Says the Beis HaLevi, that a person that is Baitech Ba'Hashem, he lives with Bitachon, he lives with reliance in the Ribbono Shel'Olam. So that itself, we're going to have to speak about it more tomorrow, but that itself is going to give the person a level of existence in this world. You will be receiving whatever it is that you need in order to continue serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the right way. Since that you can't get a real reward for mitzvah in this world, it's only that you're going to have mitzvah gereres mitzvah, one mitzvah will bring about another mitzvah, which means that it will make you enthusiastic and it will fire you up to do more mitzvahs. When a person is Baiteach Ba'Hashem, they have true faith and trust and reliance in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so then they will look at their lives and they will see, through my Bitachon, I have everything that I need in order to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the right way, and therefore I will be charged up, I will be fired up, I'll have great enthusiasm to continue pushing myself in the world of Avodas Hashem, of Torah, and of mitzvahs. So you have that one advantage, says the Beis HaLevi. It's the mitzvah gereres mitzvah. The one mitzvah will lead to another mitzvah here in this world, in the schus of your Bitachon. But secondly, says the Beis HaLevi, because that you fulfilled the mitzvah of Bitachon in the proper way in your lifetime, therefore the Keren Kayemes, the ultimate principal reward, is waiting for you ba'olam haba, in the world to come. You're not going to lose out a bit from whatever rewards a person receives in this world in the merits of their Bitachon. On the other hand, your Bitachon brings you to more mitzvahs, to more avodas Hashem, to more rewards that are going to be procured for you in the world to come. And therefore, ba'olam haba, when you reach there after 120 years, and you go through the judgments that HaKadosh Baruch has for everyone, and you pass your tests, and then Hashem begins to measure the levels of Bitachon that you live with in this world, so then the ultimate reward is going to be given over to you at that point, where you are going to see the great benefits for all that you accomplished in your lifetime as you pursue to live a life of real, true, sincere Bitachon in Hashem. Have a wonderful day.